Let's talk about the difference between discrete data and continuous data. So discrete data represents something that has been counted. So for example, could be the number of couches that were sold at the store today, right? We can count the number of couches that we sold. That makes it discrete data. It's typically going to be a whole number. So 0, 1, 2, because we can't sell half a couch, right? So we can sell one couch or we can sell two couches. We can't sell any numbers in between there, though. Which means that there's a finite number of values within an interval. And that might seem obvious right now. But when we talk about continuous data here in a second, you're going to see how it's possible to have an infinite number of values within an interval. So continuous data represents something that has been measured. So, for example, the amount of time that has passed since we last sold a couch. Right? So some common examples are time, distance, weight. Notice all of these can include decimals. It could be 2.5 hours. It could be 2 hours and 20 seconds. So there's an infinite number of values available here when we're dealing with continuous data. We could walk 1 mile. We could walk 1.1 miles. We could walk 1.15 miles. The continuous data allows us to add on as many decimals as necessary, which then means that there's an infinite number of values available in an interval.